to day 19 in our Advent devotion series. I hope you've been taking the time to put all your stars on your nativity scene. I'd love to see them all because I'm sure everybody's looks a little bit different and unique to your family. Well, today we're going to learn more about Elizabeth and Zechariah's baby boy, John. And the story is called Preparing the Way for the King, the story of John the Baptist. You might have heard of him before. And this story is from Matthew chapter 3. Elizabeth and Zechariah had their baby boy just like God had said, and they named him John, just like God had said. And as he grew up, they made sure John knew all about the promises God had made about him, how he would prepare the way for the king would bring God back. And every night they sang John to sleep with a special song. For such a long time, God seemed far away, but now he has heard what we hoped and we prayed. God is coming to earth to stay. From the time he was born, in fact, even before he was born, John had a special something about him. Some kind of special spirit, and he knew it was to help prepare the way for the king. Maybe that special spirit explains why John did some of the odd things that he did. What kind of odd things, you say? Odd things like only wearing clothes made from camel's hair. It's nice and all, but sheep's wool is cozier. Odd things like living out in the wilderness with all the wild animals. Camping is fun for a night, but it gets cold after weeks and weeks. Odd things like only eating a special snack of grasshoppers covered in honey. The honey sounds nice, but I think I'll pass on the grasshoppers. Even though John was different, God was with John. Even when he was wearing uncomfortable clothes, even when he was alone out in the wilderness, and even when he had to eat bugs, God was with John. Because God was with John, God's people went out to the wilderness to listen to him. Day after day, this is what John would say. Open up your ears and listen. Open up your hearts too, because God's got something to say. He's sending a king to make the wrong things right and the dark things light. He's sending a king who will bring God back to stay. To help everyone get ready, John baptized people in the Jordan River. It reminded everyone of all the times God had saved his people by bringing them through the water, like he did with Noah and his family. And then one day, while John was baptizing, John saw him, the man who would change his life forever, the man who would change everyone's life forever. Who do you think John saw? Do you think it was the king? Do you think it was Emmanuel? You're right, it was the king. But before the king was a man, he was a little boy. And before he was a little boy, he was what? That's right, a tiny, poor, helpless baby. While John was waiting, he would hum that song his parents sang to him each night. For such a long time, God seemed far away, but now he has heard what we hoped and we prayed. God is coming to earth to stay. And today we have a green drop of water to represent John the Baptist baptizing all the people to get them ready for when baby Jesus will come and save them. I hope you'll come back tomorrow as we get closer to that day.